Welcome back to the Bahamas Tonight Weekend Edition. BTC customers in Abaco back online tonight. This after fire and an electrical storm damaged sections of their fiber optic cable north of Treasure Key. According to BTC landlines, cellular phones and internet services were disrupted Friday night, affecting up to 12,000 customers. Technicians dispatched from New Providence repaired the damage, which included replacing more than 1,000 feet of cable. All services were restored at 3 p.m. this afternoon, with the last cell site being repaired in Red Bays. The contractor for North Eleuthera's landfill speaking out on a story aired on ZNS News Friday night. We reported that North Eleuthera residents are concerned that garbage is allegedly falling from passing trucks and affecting the wetlands. A reported foul odor and claims of uncovered garbage, and that residents are inundated by flies. Contractor Ricky Mackey explained to ZNS News in a telephone interview Saturday that he's reported to North Eleuthera police and environment health officials that scavengers reportedly set North Eleuthera's landfill on fire, and that foul odor claims are erroneous.
We come under the truck, we drop the bins, and then we come behind after we've dropped 6-7 bins and then pulverize the debris. So if you just went there where the debris just would dump, it would look like the site is unmanageable and out of control. But I assure you, that is not the case.
Any Lutheran attracting tourists to his farm for more than 10 years now, with a busy Easter weekend. And as tourists flock to several family islands for the holidays, the island farm owned by Clyde Bethel in Palmetto Point, Eleuthera, is a big hit with tourists. Bethel, who started with a love for growing produce, eventually became a full-fledged farmer. Now the agribusinessman plans to expand and says that more Bahamians should be a part of this industry. Cyan Thompson has more.
Clyde Bethel has been in the restaurant business for some 25 years. Now he's farming and loving every moment of it. Owner of Island Farm in Palmetto Point, Eleuthera, Mr. Bethel is considered among the top farmers on the island. His business has mushroomed into light manufacturing, a small food market to sell locally made goods, and a hub for tourists to Eleuthera.
In the last 9-10 years, we've expanded to 5.5 acres that we have under full production.
While Mr. Bethel supplies the local market on Eleuthera as well, tourists flock to the farm not only for produce, but for homemade breads made with ingredients grown on the farm.
We've been coming to Eleuthera for 30 years. We've been coming here probably for the last 12, I think, however long they've been open. And their breads are fabulous.
It's a big hit. There always seems to be a line waiting to get it. It's made early in the morning and it goes very quickly and it's absolutely delicious.
Island Farm is beginning to get orders from different countries, a sign that Bethel is putting a stamp of quality on Bahamian-made farm products.
Most of these products are sold locally. We sell them out at the Princess Keys, which is where all the cruise ships come into South Eleuthera. And we have orders almost every day now from Canada, the United States, even Germany, requesting our ability to ship them our product.
Bethel is certain that with hard work, planning, and the right tools, Bahamians can thrive in the farming sector.
I think it can be very beneficial to a heck of a lot of people. We just have a small farm here and the potential for its growth and expansion. We haven't even touched the tip of the iceberg in regards as to how far we can move this business along.
Cyan Thompson, ZNS News.
Filmmakers in the Bahamas are oftentimes underrated, but a small group of College of the Bahamas students say they plan to change that perception and bring a major boost to the film industry by releasing a number of their documentaries and films to thousands of students during COB's second annual film festival. The festival is free to the public and will take place this Thursday in the campus library. Showtime is at 10 a.m. Producers Tracy Ann Propal and Stephen Hanna talk about their films and what's expected.
Mine is a short film entitled En Route, and I produced it along with three other classmates, Shandia Mackey, Simba French, and Lamiche Ferguson. And basically, it's about life decisions and choices. It's based around the life of this young lady called Alyssa Smith, and it all takes place on the Bahamian public transportation system. So it's basically giving an analogy about life, about how you have different choices where you can stop, and ultimately you control the ride of your life and where you're eventual final destination is.
There are six different films showing. There are three documentaries and three short films that are fiction, I guess.
UCLB filmmaker and producer Tracy Ann Propal says these films are not only timely, but very crucial to the everyday challenges Bahamians young and old face.
Film that we produce is very important because it's about life choices, and everyone every day is being faced with choices. You know, the world is changing, and I think it can reach young people as well as an older audience, because as long as you're here on the earth, you have decisions you have to make, tough decisions that can affect how the rest of your life turns out.
We've got more Easter holiday tips from the police. This Easter Monday is the traditional start of the beach season for Bahamians. Police encourage residents to report suspicious activity and, most of all, keep a close watch on children. Here's Crime Prevention Manager Inspector Anthony Rull.
Kids to dive into unknown waters or shallow waters, and do not allow your kids to swim alone. Ask your kids to swim along the shorelines, so you'd be able to always keep an eye on your kids. And if you're caught in a rip current, children, swim sideways along with the current. Don't swim against the flow of the current.
Police Press Liaison Officer Inspector Chrislyn Skippings appeals to parents to find wholesome activities for their children, whether indoors or out.
If you must go out, parents or guardians, and even fathers, find a responsible adult and leave your child with. If you're going to a party, make sure you have a designated driver prior to you going to that party, and make sure that that person does not intake any alcoholic beverages, because we don't want any incidents occurring over this particular weekend.